quick introduction for those of you who haven't met me in person. I'm Russell Crompton, the older, the wiser, and as people keep telling me, the better looking brother of Stephen. Steve made me a very proud older brother when he asked me to be his best man at what I will know will be a fantastic wedding to his beautiful wife, George. Sorry I can't be there in person. Some of you will know the reason why. I've just finished my medical. David believes I will only strengthen the squad for the rest of the season. Seriously though, I am gutted not to be there. But on the bright side for you all, I'm not stood there with 2 gallons of Dutch courage down me trying to get through this. On the other hand though, Steve, George, you might need some to get through this. Dominic! So, if you were all standing comfortably, allow me to begin. My little brother Steve. It goes without saying, my success at fulfilling the role as big brother. A positive role model, to lead by example, and Mum, you might find this one unpalatable, but it's true, to always take the blame for my younger brother's bad behaviour. I know you're looking down on us, Dad, and agreeing with this one. Do you remember the year you had to cancel Christmas, eh, big fella? Steve waking me up at 4:30 in the morning, dragging me downstairs, insisting it was okay for us to assemble our new bikes and take them for a ride. My only mistake was to insist we put the lights on. After all, it was dark outside. If only I'd checked beforehand that Steve had secured his lights properly. I can see it as if it was only a week ago. The mangled remains of both bike and boy, after the light came loose, hit his spokes. Fortunately, Steve survived. The bike didn't. I got the blame, and Christmas was cancelled. And so from the age of 10, this is pretty much how it's been. Despite all of this, I've always admired Steve's full-on approach to life, the effort he puts into everything he does. His daughter, Dominique, the apple of his eye. A credit to you, Steve. And Dominique, cheers for being my standing best man. Steve's full-on approach to life included his sporting prowess. No matter what the sport, football, cricket, tennis, golf, Dad was always his number one fan. So much so, he even managed to find it somewhere within him to support Steve when he played for Manchester City. I would like to point out though, it was only Steve that he supported. One thing I don't want to dwell on too much was the way in which Steve embraced his midlife crisis. There is the midlife crisis top 40, and Steve You managed to tick off every single one and even had a few of your own, didn't you?
Ladies' night Adonis, working after hours, ripples on my chest, never got a night's rest.
I really did start to worry when he opened a dress shop. But in true Steve style, not just any dress shop. Oh no, not Steve. It was a shop selling the most important dress of a woman's life. Which reminds me, doesn't she look lovely? Doesn't she look beautiful? Stunning. Mum! Stand up and give us all a twirl. Seriously though, which isn't something I'm renowned for, but for once I will be. Probably the best thing Steve has ever done is ask George to marry him. I'm so glad you made that move on him at Flair's nightclub in Birmingham, George. I have never honestly seen him so happy in all the years I've known him. Thank you, George. And even though I'm not there, I've seen pictures of you already, so I know how stunning you look. Welcome to the family. Oh yes, I'd take a damn good swig of that gin. You are officially part of the Crompton clan. There are two other people who aren't with you today who've asked me to say hello. Uncle Tommy and Auntie Barbara. Fingers crossed for the knee surgery, Auntie Barbara. I was reminiscing with Auntie Barbara this week, and apparently on holiday one year, Auntie Barbara had to remind Steve to use soap to wash his face every day for 14 days. To which Steve replied, "Soap would ruin his skin and good looks." I'll leave you guests to decide if Steve continued to use water or started using soap. Whoops, I'll have to go. The boss is after me and I can't let him catch me like this. I'm also starting to feel a little bit uncomfortable. I have a little gift for you, bro. It's worked for me, well, once at least, to help me remember the day I got married. So, while you open your present, and before I go, I'd like everyone please to raise your glass to the bride and groom.
come on, Russ, there's nobody here.
Flipping heck, can't believe this. All this flipping work. Some flipping vid. Don't they realise I'm disabled and I'm putting all this flipping effort in? I'm not even going flipping wedding. Probably the best thing Steve have ever. And Dom, cheers for being best standing man. And Dom, cheers for being my best standing man. Mum! 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 Seriously though, which isn't something I'm renowned for, but for once I will be. I'd like everyone to raise their grass. Grass. Fucking grass. Gaz! Kaz?
What?
Kaz, where have you left that cream? I'm getting a rash. I got a bit of wee on it. Tilly, don't bite Daddy because he's wearing a Manchester City shirt. I said rook!